Sacramento. Welcome to the opening night of this beautiful arena. I've got a feeling we're going to have some fun in here together tonight. We got some old songs, some new songs, some in-betweeners, and we're going to have a party! the opening night of this place.
Yeah!
The most eco-friendly stadium in the world. We're going to do a song now for you, which is kind of an electronic ditty. This one's called Temporary Secretary.
Bye.
song now is a song that I wrote for my wife, Nancy. And she's here with us tonight. This one's for you, Nancy. What if it rained? We didn't care. She said that someday soon the sun was gonna shine. And she was right. This love of mine, my Valentine. As days and nights pass me by, I tell myself that I was waiting for a sign, and she appeared, not so fine, Valentine. Okay. So this next song is one I wrote for Linda.
You hold me on my mind.
Okay, thanks. You see, people bring along these signs. Yeah. And, I mean, we love the signs. We do love the signs. But what happens is, you're trying to remember your chords and the words, and you're trying to get the song right, and your mind says, don't read the signs. And then there's another side of your mind that says, yeah, go read them, it doesn't matter. If I get anything wrong, I am definitely blaming the signs. This one. Married 45 years, not been kissed by you. I thought it was just like generally. I'm still in love. I still love you. 40 years when I'm 64. Okay. I'll see you then. Before the Silver Beatles. Anyway, this is going back a long time. And we wanted to make a demo record. Me, John George, and two other guys.
Who are the other guys?
Which other guy? You wouldn't know them. Okay, Colin Hand and Duff Love.
He's right back there!
Anyway, we went to this little recording studio in Liverpool and we paid £5 to make a demo. And the song that we did that day is the song we're going to do for you now. The very first recording. Smile and fall. Started off with this musical phrase. And it went on to this one. When I call, you are alive. And you know, we'd like to dedicate that one to the great Beatles producer, Sir George Martin. And he was a beautiful guy, you know, and we thank him so much for recording us, because, I mean, if he hadn't signed us, I don't think there would be any Beatle recordings. So, pretty cool guy. That reminds me, whenever we do, of the very first session, the proper session that we had at Abbey Road Studios with George Martin. And we came in there, I mean, we were just kids, you know, we were really nervous. He was a big grown-up. And we used to do, he was, and we used to do this, we used to do Love Me Do, like, the Love Me Do. He used to go, love me do, and then the harmonica. John used to sing that, love me do, and he'd grab his harmonica and go, love me do. And George came up to me and he said, Paul, I'd like it if the harmonica could come in on the word do. So well, John can't do that. He said, will you sing love me do? I go, yeah, okay. And so I did. I did, but every time I hear that record, I can still hear the nerves and the voice, love me do.
Thank you. just fall out there. That's it. There's one guy in the team. Nope, he just left. So just fall.
All right. Okay, so way back in the 1960s, there were a lot of troubles going on, particularly in the southern states of America, over civil rights. And a lot of troubles going on over civil rights. And we would hear about this back in England, you know, on the news and stuff. And I wanted to try and write a song that if it ever got back to the people in Arkansas and Little Rock and all the people going through the struggles, that it might just help them a little bit. This moment to arise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your mind. You will all be waiting for this moment to be free. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. All your mind, you will all be waiting for this moment to arise. Singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your life. You're all waiting for this moment to be free. You are only waiting for this moment to be free. You are only waiting for this moment to be free. I'm very happy about having written that song was I go around the world and I run into people, a lot of people who say, you know, hey man, you know, I tried to learn that song, Blackbird, on a guitar, you know? How many people here tried to learn Blackbird? And you all got it wrong. You got it right? Let me see you. So, the other thing I normally say in shows is that a lot of the time you want to say something nice to someone, and sometimes you think, I'll say it tomorrow, I'll put it off, you know? And you put it off, and then sometimes it can be too late. And I wrote this next song after my dear friend John passed away. Let's hear it for John! I say, I wrote this after he passed away, and it's in the form of a conversation that we never got to have. If I said, I really knew you well, what would your answer be? If you were here today, I still remember how it was before, and I am holding back the tears no more. No, no, no. I love you. What about the time we met? What about the time? Well, I suppose if you say that we were playing hard to get, we didn't understand a thing, but we could always sing. And what about the night we cried? Cause there wasn't any reason left to keep it all inside. You never understood a word, but you were always there with a smile. I say, I really loved you and was glad you came along. If you were here today, ooh, you're in my song. So there you go. If you want to say something nice to someone, get it said. Right. We'll lift the mood a bit now. This is a song off our most recent album. This one's called Queen the Eye.
Oh,
You know, it's funny because I think we can tell which ones you like. Because, you know, like if we do a Beatles song, all the phones come. So it's like the galaxy lights up. And if we don't want you, if we do one you don't know, it's like a black hole. So here's another black hole. are from Sacramento. How many people are not from Sacramento but from somewhere nearby? And how many people not from Sacramento, not from somewhere nearby, but from somewhere else?
Yeah.
Well, on behalf of the tourist board, we welcome you. Right, we gave you our oldest song, the very first thing that we ever recorded, and now we'd like to do the most recent. This is one just from last year. And, if you want to sing along, I believe the words come up on the screen. I don't know, I'm always facing this one.
Does he care? All the lonely people.
Let's hear it for Georgie.
Yeah, we used to jam together. He had a big collection of ukuleles, and he was really good. You know, I was round at his house one day, and we were playing songs on the ukuleles, and I said to him, "I've learned one of your songs on the ukulele, you know." So we played it together that day, and we would like to play it for you. Something in the way she moved, it's exactly like no one lover. Something in the way she moves me, I don't want to leave her now. You know I'm leaving now. Somewhere in a smile she knows that I don't need no other lover. Something in his style that shows me I don't want to leave her now. You know I'm leaving now. So this next song, we're going to want you to sing on your own at one point in the song. So what I do is in the middle of the song, I'll say, now you, and you will sing most gloriously. Are you ready for that?
Thank you.
Okay, there's a story I tell that I always wanted to go back. I always wanted to go to Russia in order, if nothing else, just to sing them that song, you know? And we did get invited quite a few years back now to play a concert in Red Square in Moscow. In fact, we were the first rock and roll band to play a show in Red Square. And we had a great evening, you know, the crowd was great, those Ruskies loved to rock. And, I tell the story that we were backstage and some members of the Russian government were there because, you know, it's the Kremlin, Red Square. So they were all around the back of the stage, probably the free booze. No. Anyway, they were at the back of the stage. And one of the guys says to me, "See that guy there?" He says, "He's the defense minister of Russia." So I'm going, pretty big job, defense minister of Russia. Anyway, he comes over to me and says, "Paul, very first record I ever bought was Love Me Do." Another guy comes over, and my guys say, "Yeah, he's in the government too, you know, a tall guy." Comes up to me, he says, "We learned to speak English from listening to Beatles records." He looks me right in the eye, he goes, "Hello, goodbye." So close. It's true. In times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. just the guys, just the fellas, come on boys.
Oh,
yesterday. But we're such an evening game tonight. No one in place to hide away. Oh, I give you yesterday. Some people up from the audience who put the signs up and stuff. And So let's see who we got tonight. Who you got, Brian? Watch out. My mom has loved you since 1965. This side, this one.
Yeah.
fantastic audience here tonight. I'll tell you what though, there does come a time when we gotta go home. Yeah. Yeah, and it coincides with the time when you gotta go home. Hey, but listen, man. Before we go, to bring you a big show like this, we got a lot of people out here. We got the guys out front, Pablo on the sound. We got Wally on the lights. We got Paulie Becker on the video screens. We got all the guys on the guitars and pianos and drums, all the equipment, and concussion, the whole thing. We want to thank the greatest crew on the planet. Fantastic band of mine! Andy, Rex, Brian, Rusty. These boys can play. And most of all, as we always say, we want to thank you. Thanks for coming. Once there was a way to get back home. Once there was a way to get back home. Now say no, darling, do not cry. second commander, Dave.